arena of Liechtenstein is from the how many people can get in there. It's 1.5 as big as Vaduz. And I think 75% of the people who are in there are fans of Austria.
They're not far apart, are they? Austria and Liechtenstein.
Yeah! Woo! Okay, so when will we start the broadcasting?
It's on now.
Okay.
But we'll obviously cut it to when it starts loading qualifying. So I've got the controls like on one screen to choose the different things.
Yeah, I'm nearly halfway through the download. I guess qualifying is starting.
2:12.
Yeah, okay. I'm definitely going to make that. I'm halfway through download of the track.
It's alright, I can start talking anyway and you can join in.
Yep. Well, I can talk, but...
You can't say anything.
No, we can start with the info. But Clio Cup, so
yeah, basically with the championship, I guess I don't know how many people are watching now, so it doesn't really matter. For 5 watching now, so hello to the 5 of you. 1:30 left of practice, so me and Stefan are just having a bit of a debrief before it starts.
I'm sorry.
But yeah, basically, Stefan, so you've got Hector and Carter are separated by like 12 points, I think.
Alright. Well, Hector and David are the fastest people around here. Rich is also in that company. I think Alan, if he gets it right, his setup right, he really depends on the setup he's having. He's also as quick as them.
Yeah, we've got Stefan's still downloading Thruxton, so. But we've got, from practice, with 50 seconds left, Hector's on fastest, Arne is 6.
Oh, yeah, Arne.
Yeah, it's just under a tenth. And then Lewis McLeay, 2.6 tenths. Alan, 5 yeah. tenths. And David Carter, 7.4 tenths off. Then Pete Bingham, 8 tenths. Rich, 1 tenth.
Wait. David is 7 tenths?
David Carter, yeah, 7 tenths off.
Wow. Hector. Hector's really on pace today.
Yeah, so the championship, Hector's first with 451 points.
Yeah.
And no, Carter's got 427. 32 yeah. points for a win, so my maths is awful. Basically, Rich to come needs both of them to DNF in both races.
Yeah, no, Hector's got the championship, there's no doubt about it. David and Rich, as every time close battles, Rich still have a big chance of the second place.
excuse me.
I think Alan is third or fourth?
Yeah. Alan is, yeah, fourth. And then you, Stefan, and you haven't raced for ages.
No.
Right, so we're into qualifying. Stefan, you still downloading, yeah?
Yeah, 75%, something like that.
So we've got 20 seconds until the session starts. I've actually put on the weather widget because, well, it's likely to rain at some point.
Oh, cool.
In both races.
I don't know who's watching, so if you don't know Thruxton, it's maybe as you have already seen it, a very fast right-handed track. I think it's just three left-handers, so yeah, it's
okay, that's, sorry Stephen to interrupt, D. Taylor is driving into people on the warm-up lap before people have even got round the first lap, so not really sure what that's about.
Ben Hammer. But yeah,
I suppose, Stefan, but actually we should introduce ourselves really as well, shouldn't we? Do you want to introduce yourself?
Well, okay, as you've already heard, my name is Stefan Schlacher. I am originally from Austria, and yeah, I'm broadcasting today with Mark,
which
should be your main commentator today.
Yeah, as Stefan said, my name's Mark Harris. I've been more and more involved with the Clio Cup recently through different things, but I've actually just been diagnosed with gout in my foot, and I am only 29 years old, which so it's a bit of a shock, and I can't actually walk at the moment. So I was going to drive, but I can't because it's too painful, so I was thinking about maybe broadcasting it, and Stefan very kindly offered to help me, so here we are.
Cars I had to choose a car.
Yeah, you do, mate. Yeah.
No, no. The fuck. So yeah, Thruxton, the Clios, very suitable for the Clios. As I said, right-handed track, nearly all the way right. The Clios max out in their last gear about 300 meters before the breaking point for the chicane. Now I'm also in the server, so I can commentate properly.
Brilliant.
Arne with his Renault livery.
Nobody's put in a quick lap yet, so we're still waiting for people to come around. I was going to follow Hector because he was the first out of the pits and the quickest, but I think you kind of saw what happened. The less we say about that for the time being, the better. So we will follow for the time being Arne, I think. He's coming round the back part of the circuit.
Straight. You can hear the max out at the in the last corner. In the last gear. Breaking point is around 150 meters. And this chicane is pretty funny, you just saw it at Arne. There is a big, big hill in the second corner of the chicane. So you...
So we go, Arne goes quickest.
You have to set the car properly up. You have really to stop turning because of that bump. If you are still turning, you will spin in the Clio.
Right, on board Ivana now as we come round the back section of the circuit through Noble, I think this is, yep. To the right, round Goodwood. Yes, I do have a map of the circuit in front of me, I'm not just like reeling these out of nowhere.
Okay, I just thought you were reeling
gone off.
This track.
I do like this track, but yeah. So, okay, let's jump on board with Arne. As you can hear that maxing out, it's a horrible noise.
Yeah, it's... Dun, 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 dun.
So we're coming up to the chicane, we see the cars bouncing over the curbs. Bang. 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 It's Lars, what's that, goes into sixth place. And Arne is pulling over. Let's follow David. See, everyone's pulling over now. Let's come back out and do another lap. Let's follow Richard for a while.
Ross Downing and Luke Ridgway still no time set.
What cameras?
What?
So we're on the bonnet of Rich now.
Look, 6 seconds slower than Arne. Wow. Well, we have the top five within, let's say, 7/10. Richard is sixth with 1.3 seconds behind Arne. So it could be. Well, we have a new time. Ross Doning with 8/10, slower than Arne, which puts him in sixth.
So following Rich now around the back section up to the chicane.
I should join. Behind him is Hector.
Let's see what lap Rich does. Rich does a 123.9.
Yeah, 4/10.
And let's go on board with Hector, because he's 4/10 down at the moment. I'm pretty sure that's not his fastest pace for sure. Let's follow him around on the track camera. Through this tricky section, hold on the acceleration, through this right-hand kink, back out onto the back bit. It's pretty much flat, isn't it, Stefan, all of this back bit?
Yeah, what's really funny, that right-hander onto that bended straight, so to say, is very crucial, because if you can set up your car properly, you can go full speed, so to say, through the right hander, which gives you major advantage against other cars.
Definitely. I always found at Thruxton, you almost forget, because this section is so long and you're on the throttle pretty much for so long, you forget that the chicane's coming up. You kind of it's very, very difficult to lose, well, it's very easy to lose concentration and forget that you've got this really hard chicane coming
Whoa,
up.
Whoa, Hector going wild over the curbs.
See what lap time he does. Hector does a...
Yep, it was lower than his personal best, so...
It was. I think it didn't actually count. He must have cut the curb or something, because it didn't come up on the screen.
Yeah.
Right, let's follow for a bit. Let's follow Sasha, for no reason in particular. He's just coming across the line now. Sasha currently a 2. That's a 125.9. So he doesn't actually improve there. That was a 125.9, his best was a 124.8. Let's follow Luke.
Okay, Luke doesn't have the Pitlanes livery on my screen.
No, he hasn't. He just picked one at random for this race. It's nice, nice livery though, not a real one. So these guys now really... That's it. If they're not coming out of the pits now to get back round for the checkered flag, they're going to miss their last run.
David Carter's going out. And I see Arne is also is going to drive out just like Louis. No, sorry.
Louis is out, isn't he?
Not out.
Yeah, Louis has run out of time. I know he's coming out. He's not going to get a lap in, so there's no point. Right, let's see if what Hector can do. This will be his last flying lap.
So yeah, Arne is still in first, but just 0.065 seconds in front of Lewis, which is around 3/10 of a second in front of David. None of those three are able to counter Hector if he's going to drive a faster lap.
Hector's best was a 123.2. And he doesn't improve.
Well, he is still driving, so maybe he can go faster now.
I wish this plug-in thing showed you like split times.
Well.
So he's coming up to the second split now. Hopefully, it'll give me a little thing showing.
split time was 13.9.
Doesn't say whether it's quicker or slower, which is a bit pants, really.
This corner, which Hector just drove through, is also a bit tricky because, as you can see, there is a let's say bump in the apex of the. Ooh, I think it cut the chicane. In the middle of the apex, so it can get you unsettled.
122.7, Hector goes pole there, Stefan. He absolutely smashed that at the end.
I think you can protest it. Because, yeah, he was with all four tyres, even over the...
Let's get the Rich. Rich is on a hot lap. She's coming around now. His best is 123.6. Rich goes faster. 123.2.
Yeah.
Brilliant, pretty exciting in there. Well done, Rich, well done, Hector. My money, I think, I have to say, for the race will be on Rich. I reckon. Who do you think?
Hector.
Mr. Schlecker, you reckon?
Yep. I think Hector is gonna run away with it.
Right, tell you what I'm going to do, Stefan, is I'm going to go back out into the main room and we're going to have a word with Rich and see what he thinks. And it is now absolutely lashing it down with rain.
Yes.
Look how much weight they put on living with us.
Hi, Rich. I hope you don't mind me jumping over. We were just watching that last lap there. You kind of pulled that out of the bag, didn't you, to move up quite a few places?
Yeah, it was all right, wasn't it?
Yeah, and we saw Hector come through and just get in with 20 seconds to go and go into pole, which was pretty spectacular, and then you came in there at the end as well.
It always helps to do it at the end because then you're getting as much real road as possible as well. So
very good. Who else we got? Pete, how did your qualifying session go, buddy?
Well, my first session out was pretty tragic. Kept stepping off the track, but then I managed to stick a lap together in the second session out.
Yeah, can see you are starting sixth, which is not bad at all.
Yeah, I'd have been higher if Rich hadn't bagged it in the last one.
And Luke, how did that go?
Bad.
Bad? Any particular reason?
I'm slow.
Fair enough. Right then, guys, I'm going to dip back out and hope to speak to you after the race. But good luck to everybody. Cheers, guys. See you later.
Cheers.
Bye.
Right, cool.
All right.
So yeah, what's the weather going to be like in the race? Eh? It looks rather interesting. Oh, there's Lars on the grass.
So the rain.
It could be. It could absolutely lash it down in the middle of the race. I genuinely don't know.
Well, it's not the intensity set to 15. It's the chance set to 15%, so yeah, it should rain, but Rich did a mistake, so
yeah.
Who knows, mate, this is going to be very, very difficult. I would probably stick with slicks. Yes, I would start with slicks. You can't start on wets in this, it'd just destroy them. Although, saying that, at Simmons Plains in the last BTCC race, I think the track was dry enough for slicks and I stayed on wets and I won the race, so I don't know, and I didn't really have any problems with overheating.
Well, it's the thing. It starts raining again.
I can hear rain.
It's the thing. You're... have the security with the wets if you want, but they are slow on the dry conditions. So what are you going to do? Are you going for the safety while going to, let's say, you're risking that it's going to clear up and you're going to be fast. But you still have the risk that you slide and crash into the barrier or something like that.
I can see the little tire marks behind the cars now, and there's starting to be a little bit of spray.
Yeah, and also the spray, yeah. So, I would go for the wets.
You would go wets.
No doubt about it.
Yeah, I think based on what it looks like now, it would have to be wets.
Yeah. But this would be an interesting race if it clears up and the road gets drier and drier. For everybody who is not familiar with the Pitlanes Clio, we have two races. The first one is 10 minutes, the second one is 20 minutes. It looks like Lewis is on the rise because he was sliding around. So the guys are testing out what they can use and how good the tires are.
Definitely. This seems to be a more important warm-up session than normal. I don't normally go out in warm-up.
Well, David and Lewis have the tries on it. You can see it because they went really, really wide in the second last corner. And sliding around in the braking zones.
Yeah.
Wow.
Carter looks like he's really struggling through there.
Yeah. No chance for Slicks.
No, it's looking very skiddy out there now.
Yeah, you can see first corner they are going horrendously
straight off
wide.
The track. Yeah.
Yeah. Looks like, what was that, Nürburgring? First corner. Everybody sliding around like shit. So yeah.
Cool. Right. Who shall we focus the camera on at start and Stefan, do you think?
I would say you should go with Rich, cause he's fourth. And he's where's David? David was seventh?
I think so, something like that.
Yeah, then David Carson, though, he's a really good starter if he gets it right.
Yeah, I think I'm definitely going to stick with Rich. And Slicks are definitely not an option, just watching.
No. They also, okay, the Brit we have is Hector Thompson in first, then Arne Schoenwild, Lewis McLeod, our top threes. Then we have Richard Goodwin and David Carter completing the top five. Pete Bingham, Alan van Hoeke, Ross Downing, Luke Ridgway and Lars Wozzeck are completing the top 10. André Günther, Clyde Whiting, Sascha Krüger, Tony Belafronte, Paul McLeod and last but not least, David Taylor.
Excellent. Thank you for that, Stefan. Right, we're going to start on the nose of Rich and then we're quickly going to... Actually, no, we're not. We're going to start with the TV because we can see a bit more around.
Yeah, I'm watching David.
Right, red
there
lights
we
on.
Go.
And we are green. Let's see what happens. Looks
yeah,
like David's had a great start.
Lewis with a bad start. We're a bad start, losing two positions before the first corner.
Oh, and Rich has been tagged. Great save.
Wow, what a save. No corners so far.
Oh, well, David Taylor's off at the back.
David Taylor, yeah. But it looks like most of the guys are still on Slicks.
So David's looking down the inside. Goes through. You can tell Rich is leaving
and
lots
Lewis
of room.
Is also through.
It's a bit bumpy.
Or not.
Oh, big Arnage, slide in, Arnage. Lewis
Rich.
Has hit Rich. Rich has saved that again.
Wow.
Once this first lap's over, we'll have a little recap. I think Hector is gone.
Oh, gone, yeah.
Hector and Arna are having a great battle at the front.
Front to nose.
Let's watch these two. I'm sure there's lots of stuff going on in the middle, but this is pretty hot.
And Arne is taking the inside against Ellen. And he threw. Oh, Hector. I'm sorry. I'm not Ellen. Think Hector made a mistake.
Swatch Clyde. Good mid action. Clyde's gone wide.
Yeah, middle, big pack. Probably the most action. Paul McLeod is in front of that pack, which is now 3 wide.
We're watching them come into the chicane.
Yeah, Paul is backing out of that. Good move, clever move. Safety first.
Oh, looks like Pete's gone wide.
No, it's not Pete.
No, it wasn't, was it? It was another blue and white car. Oh.
And we have a crash in the back again. It was again David Taylor.
How did he manage to catch up and then crash again?
Probably
right.
Was in the grass.
So we've got Arne first, Hector second, Bat second behind, Rich third, big gap.
Again.
David Carter just behind.
David Carter made again a mistake because David was 2 seconds in front of Rich.
Oh, more bumping and going on in the background. Oh, Clyde's been tagged, he's gone off. Right, let's see if we can watch what happened during the first lap.
Wow, Arne is flying, he's now 1.5 seconds in front of Hector.
Clyde and Andre having a great battle here for 14th and 15th place. Good battle with Alain. Everyone after that first few laps seems to be behaving themselves. I think the best action is here with
Where
Ross.
We have again 3 wide.
Oh,
David Carter made again a mistake. He's really not on form today. Think he is on slicks.
Ross has got past.
All over the place. Wow, the guys are really. Everybody, I think, is on slicks. It seems like that Arne is on wet and everybody else is on slicks. Because Hector is sliding around, but Arne, as far as I saw it, is the only one of the top few guys who are not sliding around.
Alain looking around the outside of Lewis there, couldn't quite make it stick. Coming back round to the back section of the track. I mean, the top three, I think, is almost pretty much guaranteed now, isn't it, Stefan? Arne first, Hector second, Richard third. I can't really see any of those making a mistake.
Well,
Lewis is basically pushing David along the back.
We have a chance of rain, so never say never.
Lewis has gone around the outside of David, but of course these guys are teammates, so I would imagine they would give each other a little bit more room than others.
And as I said, it starts raining again.
Is
so
it raining?
Arne is on the wet tires, so he should be have no problem. I'm not sure with Hector. I said he's on but yeah. Rich is catching up to Hector, and I think Rich is on wet, because he's not sliding around.
We're following Lewis here, thought he was going to be close enough to have a look at David into the chicane, but he's nowhere near.
Yeah, we now have also spray.
Yeah, you can see the rain now falling on the track. So we have one non-finisher so far, which is David Taylor.
Yeah, Hector is on dry. He's driving around. Richard has wet on it. You can see it clearly. And he's catching up to Hector.
So I'm still getting used to this interface of what you can do. So apparently on this thing at the top, I should be able to see the gap between people.
Lars is in the pits, probably changing to wet tires as it again stopped raining.
So difficult to choose.
Yeah, it's really difficult, but Lars is definitely going to change his tires. He was
the gap's kind of stabilised between Rich and Hector. There's not really much going on. So let's go back to Alain. I think that's where the most action is kind of happening. We've got this tale of David Carter, Lewis McGlade. Sasha Kruger come from nowhere up into 7th place, which is good to see. David Carter's gone off, you can see that in front. Sasha's gone off as well, both of them onto the grass.
Yeah, they are not dry, you can see it. So, our first three guys are still Anish Schoenwild, and he's now 7.448 seconds in front of Hector Thompson, who is second, of course, and in third we have Richard Goodwin with a gap of 12.642 seconds to Arne Schoenwild.
Alan's had a good run here on Sasha. Just looks left, looks right, looks left again.
No way to go through.
I think we're going to stick with this Sasha battle for a while.
Wide.
Sasha's gone wide, yeah. Definitely going to stick with this, I think, for a bit. 2 minutes, 50 seconds to go over the race.
Clyde and Donny are battling for 11th place. And André Günther went a bit wide. The chicane. Think.
Oh, massive
Lars
slide. Alan's on the power. Just in the middle of the straight, pretty much. Just put his foot down and just slid all over the place. He's gone wide. Sasha's gone wide.
Yeah.
There is literally no grip on this circuit right now.
All washed off, and that's the really cool thing about.
And Luke's gone past. That was a good move. Right, so in theory, I should be able to press this and watch what happened. Oh, it doesn't work. This thing does not work. This replay thing we're going to have to look at. So basically you've got a list of all the things that have happened. So I've pressed on Luke Ridgway is now 8th place. He overtook Alan. I'm trying to press replay and it doesn't... Oh, no, we've managed to get that one. Anyway, let's go back to live.
We have someone standing there in the chicane. Sasha Kruger made a big mistake. He's now down to 13th.
Managed to catch the end of that incident.
I don't know what happened at this corner, so I'm sorry.
We're watching Lewis behind David Carter. It's probably the closest kind of events at the moment. Let's go to Paul McLeod. He's following Alan now. Seems to be struggling. I think Paul's on wets. Alan's on dries.
Yeah.
With 1 minute to go. Oh, that's a shame. Sasha Kruger, obviously, terminal damage. Has not been able to carry on.
Had a good race to the point. Probably some... did you know what happened?
He lost it at the chicane. I will try and have a look at the end of the race, I think, Stefan. We'll keep with this for the next 30 seconds towards the end. Following André... Apologies about your pronunciation of names. That's why I've got an Austrian with me, I think. André Günther. Coming up to the chicane. Oh, no, coming around the right-hander. Oh, Clyde's a little bit of a wobble. He's looked down the inside. Can't quite make that stick. Arne will be now on his last lap, I would have thought.
Don't know. But now, probably three wide, no?
Clyde's gone up the inside. He's trying on Alain.
No. Just was a battle between Clyde and Paul McLeod.
So we are on the last lap now. We'll watch Clyde and Alain go round. Like I said, Alain, if he is on slicks, this is great driving. If Clyde's on wets, to keep him behind so far. But I have to say, I think Clyde's going to get him before the end of the race.
This could now be a problem. We have in front Lars Wozzeck.
2 laps down.
Yeah, he's 2 laps down.
I'm sure he'll just move over, I would have thought. I'd hope so.
Yeah, let's hope so.
So come onto the back section for the last time. We'll see if Clyde can get him. But for the time being, we'll jump to Arne and watch him. He's coming into the chicane for the last time. Been quite a straightforward race for him. He's driven very, very well. 8 seconds approximately of Hector. Arne comes across the line. to win race one. Well done, Arna, very well deserved. Watch Hector come through in second. That pretty much is the championship, I would say. Hector come in second, David come in fifth.
Our new champion of the season. So, now,
let's Clyde jump back to Clyde.
Of Ellen, but he's think too far away from Ellen. He looked to the inside.
Oh.
Yeah, no. Maybe even lose the place to André Günther.
He's going to lose the place. Lose the place. André has it. Up into ninth. Clyde finishes tenth. Here we go. Good race. Donny, not really seen Donny at all. Let's have a little look at Donny coming past. In your old team colours, Stefan. Here we go. Well done. Let's see. We'll try and see what happened to Sasha. This thing isn't very good, I have to say. It is amazing, but there we go. I enjoyed that. Good race. Right, let's see if we can go and jump in and go and say hello to some people. Right, Stefan, I will speak to you again in a second. Well done, guys. That was a good first race. Very changeable conditions. Let's come to you first, Rich. Third place. How do you think that went? The first lap was a bit, quite a lot of contact made between various people there. What did you think of it?
I don't really fully know what happened. I know at one point, I think coming up to the first corner, I was, or maybe out of it, I was fully sideways at full exit lap. And then, to be fair, I think I probably came across on Lewis. I was thinking about it while I was driving. There was that much going on. I didn't realise he was to my right. I thought, with him being round the outside at turn two or three, I thought I'd be like away from him, sort of thing, and be able and have that gap. But I didn't, and I think I maybe turned across him. But I really don't know, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't think there was anything particularly intentional going on. I think there might have been a mix of tyres in that race. Quite a few people were just literally understeering off around the fast corners, especially after that first rain shower during the race. Luke, how did your race go, buddy?
It went pretty well, to be honest. I left a bit too much life in the tyres, unfortunately. I was going quite slow at the start, preparing for people's tyres to drop off, and I finished the race with like 3/4 of the tyres left, so I had a lot more pace in the bag.
Yeah, there was quite a lot of stuff going on in the mid-pack. We're still trying to figure out this thing, but we saw Sasha, I think it was, go off at the chicane. I don't know if you... I think you were behind that when it happened, but if not, we don't know. Did you kind of see what happened?
Yeah, just missed his breaking point and went straight on, and then didn't want to rejoin the track in a dangerous place, so stayed wide.
Very good. While, for some reason, has it booted everyone out of the server?
I'm restarting it. I'm doing the admin stuff.
Okay, cool. Yeah, sorry, I can't remember. That's fine. Pete, first lap didn't really favour you, did it? It didn't go too well. Again, I'm not really sure what happened. I was trying to keep up with everybody, but you kind of got shuffled back to the pack.
Yeah, I got a nudge in the back from Lars Watzak. No, just a racing incident, but it meant that me, him and André ended up disappearing off the track for a while. And then on my way back through the field, because I had quite a good pace until the second bit, I went 3 wide into turn 4 with Clyde and someone else and ended up spinning Clyde, so apologies Clyde when you talk to him. And then after that second downpour, I totally misjudged my braking into turn 1 and disappeared off and did some gardening.
Yeah, there's quite a few times when we were just scrolling through the cars where quite a few cars spent quite a lot of time on the grass in that race. It looked very, very hard to control. Clyde, are you up for talking at all?
Sorry, Clyde, I really am.
No, how did that go, Claire? There was some good racing. We saw on the last lap there that, unfortunately, in trying to overtake Alan, you ended up getting overtaken, which was unfortunate. But good race from you.
Yeah, not too bad. I just don't like the rain.
No, I know what you mean. Right then, guys.
Being a potato, I thought you'd like it.
Right, guys. I will hopefully catch up with you after the second race, and we'll see how it goes. Good luck, everyone.
Cheers,
mate. Right, we're back with Stefan.
All right.
Hello. Yeah, so, weather for this one. Yeah, I don't really know what it's going to be. I am finding this hard with this broadcast to kind of keep up with everything that's going on. I'm really going to have to look at how to use the replay feature, I think, because it doesn't seem to jump back, but never mind. There we go. So I hope the 5 people, which isn't a lot really, is it, watching right now are enjoying the action. And hopefully we're not completely embarrassing ourselves with the commentary. What's the score in the football, Stefan?
Well, Austria versus Liechtenstein. Austria is 2-0 in front.
2-0.
But yeah, our main topic is the racing going on in Thruxton, our virtual Thruxton. And, well, because it's rear road and the rear road gets saved off over the restart, we still have a wet track, which you can see is drying up.
I think as well, we have to say congratulations to Hector. I think I am awful at maths, but based on just what we were looking at, he definitely is the Clio Cup champion. So, well done to Hector. I think probably deserved over the season, I would say. Agreed,
yeah,
Stefan?
For sure.
Yes, definitely.
Hector has good pace, is also consistent over the races.
I have no idea why it did that. I think it must do some kind of like thing after a certain amount of time. It kind of archives or saves or something. I don't really know.
Okay.
So, guys, just finishing their warm up 1 minute ago. Really want to be racing. I have to say, this one looks like it would have been good.
Alright, 30 seconds to go. Just a quick look, because we have the grid reversed, so Lars is on the pole, because... No, sorry, David is here. So David Taylor is on the pole.
I know who I'm watching then.
Is second. Then we have Sascha Krüger, third. Good enough. Pete Bingham is fourth. Paul McLeod, fifth. Then we have Doni Belafronte, sixth. Clyde is 7th, then André Günther 8th, Alan van Hoeke is 9th, Luke Ridgewell is completing our top 10 of the grid. Luke Ridgewell is 11th, have to move up again. Lewis McLeod is 11th, David Carter is 12th, Ross Downing is 13th, Richard Goodwin 14th, and Hector Thompson and Anish Schoenbild are completing our grid of position 15 and 16.
Here we go then. So, completely different, as Stefan mentioned, we have a reversed grid for these second races. They're slightly longer as well, aren't they? They're 20 minutes.
Yeah, doubled.
Let's make this big.
Okay, now again, I will watch David Carter because he can really slingshot out of his grid box, going into the cockpit of him. He's standing behind Luke.
I'm going to focus on Lars Wozzeck. So we have, I think it's Team Ahorn Racing, I think they're called, and they're both first and second. Actually, I think Pete has got a good chance of winning it. And we are go for race two at Thruxton.
Yeah, we're green. Don't know what. Oh, David, yeah, really slingshot of David. Already passed two people. Now Donnie in front of him. Alan van Hoeke, also very good start of him.
It's all nice and fourth clean already. So far.
Or fifth.
Just follow Clyde. Clyde looked like he had a good run, running outside of his teammate.
Wow, guys are braking really early. Really, really early for this corner.
Oh, big crash behind. Danny running outside.
Yeah. We have two wide now between Paul McLeod and Luke. Lewis. Why is it always Luke?
Two L's.
Now through the left hander.
Lars has gone wide.
Alright, some technical difficulties as we go into the chicane.
Big slap.
I'm still on board with David.
Just
to get a feel. I think now everybody is on slicks. On
wets. So Lewis McLeod is coming after Pete Bingham at the moment with Lars Wozzeck in third. Let's see what Lewis can do here. Let's jump on board. Looking down the inside. That breaks Pete. Pete's still on the inside. We go round. Pete's managed to hold him off this time. Let's follow them for one lap. This is for the lead. It's all going on. We've got somebody just behind. Let's jump in with Alan in third. He's following Lewis very closely. It's all neat and tidy at the front so far. Is there anything going on mid-pack, Stefan? I'm watching first, second and third at the moment.
Yeah, I'm also watching David, but I will look. Paul is... So, okay, let's go through the grid after first.
David's up the inside of Alan at the moment, coming into the chicane. Is he going to get it done?
Well, because...
Oh, they touched! He's pushed him off. That was... dreadful, really. And Lewis has got past Pete as well. Pete's coming back up the inside. Pete's driving very well.
Pete's really good driver in the wet. I already noticed that. So, okay, after two laps, we have Pete Bingham in first, Lewis McLeod in second, David Carter third, Ross Downing fourth, Sascha Krüger fifth, Lars Wozzeck sixth, seventh is Andre Günther, eighth, just only Richard Goodwin. Ninth, Paul McLeod. Hector Thompson is completing our top 10. Then we have Clyde Whitting. In 12th is Luke Ridgway. 13th is Donny Belafronte. Arne Schönwild is just 14th. And Donny is now for 15th. And Alan van Hoeke has a DNF.
Yeah, unfortunately, David Carter, we were on board at the time, they had a bit of an accident and drove into each other there. Obviously going to sit on the fence and not say any blame or anything like that, but it looked like it could have been avoided, should we say. Perhaps a bit of a rush of blood.
If you're still in the cockpit, you can see we have a dry line up to the last chicane, till the breaking point. Then it's already again wet. Through the last chicane, we already have again a dry line. So, yeah.
Just Hector following Paul. So we're coming up to fast flying right-hander Church, I think that one's called. Past the Portaloo on the left hand side. Everything else is pretty spread out.
Yeah, surprisingly. we had such a good and competitive race, first race, but now we have already a 3 second gap between third and fourth.
Long way to go. 15 minutes or 14 minutes still to go, and the top three are still within a second, so.
Yeah. But Pete is really holding his car together, not making a single mistake. Okay, he made a mistake, so.
I definitely don't think he's out of it. I think he's going to catch back up to Lewis, I think. Especially with that pressure from behind. So we've got Andre and Lars quite close. Oh, Sasha's gone wide. Comes back on the track. Andre's looking down the inside. And Davey's got past Pete, typically, as we move past. And, oh, contact! Slams into the side of Sasha. Sasha keeps going and, oh, just comes straight back across the track, right in front of them. That's. Rich won't mind. That's two places he's gained there in one corner.
We have another two, sadly, who are not long in the race. It's Donny Belafonte. It says suspension. And David Taylor is in the pits, driving out now. So he still can race. So we only have two DNFs so far.
Trying
with Alan van Hoeke and Donny Belafonte.
I'm pressing on Donny, like pressing replay, and it's not doing anything. It's stupid.
We have three wide into the chicane between Lewis and David. Well, Lewis let David.
Oh,
go past.
Pete, no! Pete's lost it there. Comes back on. Got majorly sideways in the braking zone. He's trying so hard. Lewis has had a bit of a poor run though out of the chicane, so Pete's looking back up the inside. Don't, do you know what, and it sounds stupid, don't write Richard Goodwin out of this yet. He's only 5 seconds behind, in sixth. He's not that far behind these guys, and there's still another 12 minutes to go. Pete looks around the outside to Lewis to do the switch back into the left-hander. Not quite managed it this time.
Whoa, really jumped that curb.
This, of course, is allowing Lars, Richard, Hector all to catch up to this little group. And Richard's also got past Lars.
Lewis made a mistake.
Pete's
now
past.
Third and Ross, second, and Ross Downing is in the tail of Lewis. So we have now the top four.
We are following it. They're within 1.3 seconds of each other. Hector's past Lars as well, so Richard and Hector, we know, are quicker, kind of catching up to this group as well.
It really seems like Lewis and David are driving on wets, because they went to the outside of the corner to
cool the tires down. Yeah, I'd be on wets. No way would I be on dries.
You know what? I think
fastest lap from Hector there. Second quicker than anybody else.
Dries. I really think that Pete is on dry.
Rich is only 2 seconds behind this group now. This is getting exciting.
Oh, Rich. Major slide. But he's definitely catching up. Because the guys are battling. I see Ross has a custom paint job on his car and forgot to shut down the
wireframe.
Yeah.
That's alright. So we're following Richard now. He is 3 seconds behind this group. You can see them in front.
And behind him is Hector Thompson.
Yep. Let's even jump behind even further and go to Hector.
And
right behind Rich.
He is down another place. Ross Downing just went through to third.
Hector has a massive run. He's looking at the inside. Pete's obviously had a mistake as well, so he's actually going to block
Lewis
Hector's
made
line.
Also a mistake. Ross is now outside of him on the dry line.
Wow, this is getting six cars now in the lead group.
David is really not on pace today. You can see it every time through the chicane they catch up to him.
So that's another DNF for David Taylor. That's both races.
Okay, now we have four as rated as DNF.
At the moment, Stefan, we're just I'm on the bonnet cam of Hector following this group of
all right.
six Lewis cars.
McWhite, but managed to hold it on and still second.
Oh, look at him go to the inside.
Oh shit. Holy shit.
Oh, they're getting close.
Okay. Sorry. Just so I really, really bad accident in football.
Pete's still in this. Rich is in this. Ross is having a great race, isn't he?
Yeah. Now we have the top six, nose to tail. So it gets exciting again, and you can see David is cooling his tire, so he's definitely on wet. Think Rich with his pace, he's definitely on slicks. Ross Downing is now in second, or Lewis is still holding on, but now he's outside.
Oh, Ross Winklet. Ross got sideways. Was there contact there, Stefan?
The problem was Lewis didn't let have Ross enough room, and he got sideways. So now we have only the first five. Nose to tail, and Rich is looking at the inside of Pete.
And then that's causing Hector to look at the inside of Rich. It's getting very, very exciting.
That's why Ross is again back.
This all, of course, is allowing David to get away at the front.
Yeah, he's now 1 second in front of Lewis.
We're still here just following on the bonnet cam of Hector. I think it's definitely the best place to be at the moment. Let's jump to Ross. Been more of a calm lap this time. I think everyone's kind of regathering their thoughts about what to do over the next few laps. I can't see this staying in the same order for the rest of the race though, Stefan, can you?
Well, it's 7 minutes to go. Everything can happen. We have two wide between Pete and Lewis. Now is Rich in a very good position for third place against Pete.
Literally pushing Pete along the straightaway there. Is he going to be able to keep the tight line? He's pushing Pete again, nips to the inside. Lewis has had a very poor run out of that corner.
No, Rich has Pete. Or not. Wow, good driving by Pete. But now he's the inside, yeah. And Hector, no, he's not getting through. And I think David hasn't got the right tires for these conditions.
No, he does backing them up a bit.
Yeah, they are getting really close to David again and again on the straight to the chicane. So
quite a few people diving over to the wet line. Pete, David, all diving over.
You can clearly see who is on the wet tyres and who's not, so...
So, Pete is having a look up the inside of Ross now into the chicane.
Rich just overtook Lewis, who was in the draft, and Rich has not got the draft. That's how fast the dry tyre is against compared to the dry tyre.
So let's follow Rich here. He's definitely the man on a mission.
Yeah.
Pete has gone up the inside of Ross.
David made a mistake and Rich is through.
Oh, three wide into the right hander. They've kind of stopped it. They've given each other room. Rich comes. To be honest, I can see Rich pulling away now, Stefan.
Yeah, definitely. David is gonna holding up everybody else. Lewis is not going to overtake him, that's for sure. So we have two slow cars in front of Hector. Well, Hector, it will not take Hector too long to overtake them, because he's also on dry tires, slicks.
But he's looking on the outside.
On the wet line. Wow.
Rich is gone, isn't he?
Wow,
Hector. What a move, wow. Hector. That was incredible. Well done, yeah, Hector.
That's the difference between a dry and a wet tire. There, I can see it. And now, oh, carnage. Pete and David.
I was still watching Hector following that move through.
Yeah, Pete had his nose inside and David tried to shut the door, but Pete already had his nose there and he clipped Pete.
Oh, now having a look at Luke here for 6th and 7th place. I think it's only going to make that move stick down the inside. Yep. Pretty straightforward past that, really. Luke's run wide, unfortunately. Let's jump back to Hector. Hector's catching Rich quite quickly now.
Okay, we have 3 minutes to go, and to update you on the standings, Rich first, Hector is second, Lewis is third, David Carter is fourth.
Then a bit Rostown of a gap now.
Is fifth. Then we have Anne Schoenwild, Luke Ridgway, Pete Bingham, Lars Wozzeck, André Günther, that's our top 10. Then we have Clyde and Paul McLeod, who is 4 laps behind. We could also see that
Hector's looking for first up into the chicane now.
Oh yeah.
Rich taking the defensive line on the inside. Hector's done him around the outside, I think.
No.
Rich
no,
comes no. back.
But what we will have is
Lewis catching both of them. Lewis is going to do Hector.
Clyde is just 1 minute and 19 seconds back. And yeah, Hector is down to start.
So one, probably 2 laps left now, isn't it?
Yeah.
So this has been a relatively calm lap compared to the last ones. Yeah, of course,
I think of the top 5, David Carter is the only one with wet tires. Because now that Lewis went by David, he is as quick as Rich and Hector.
Well, guys, another piece of exciting news. This last lap will be the last lap of the Clio Cup. As we originally known it. You may have noticed that some of the cars have slightly different paint schemes, particularly Richard's has got the yellow writing and different stickers on. This is the last lap of the last race of the normal Pitlanes Clio Cup Championship. Next year it will be the officially licensed, sanctioned Michelin Clio Cup Series with the new paints. Everyone has to have a paint, everyone is already formally registered and things for it, but just shows the progress that this Clio Cup has made and the exciting racing that is on offer every week and every Friday. So be sure to come, and if you can't get involved, join another league, because rFactor 2 really is a great thing to be using. And yeah, if you can't get on board, come and watch us. It's always good fun, isn't it, Stefan?
Yeah, for sure. As you can see, the only battle we really have now is between Ross Downing in 6th and Luke Ridgway in 7th, who are now side by side in the last lap, because we just had the 20 minutes mark. So yeah. Well, in those 2 seconds, we are three laps we had, David Carter is now 8 seconds behind Richard.
In fact, everyone has split up for this last lap, so it's going to be a bit of a procession, unfortunately, but the racing that happened before was well worth watching. Very, very, very good. You know what? Nothing really...
Well, David could still be get overtook by Ross.
Right, so we're going to watch Rich come across the line to win. What a great win there by Rich as he pulls over to the pit lane.
Great driving.
Hector, that move around Lewis running outside of the quick section was pretty amazing as well.
So now it's official, Hector. Congratulations.
Definitely, congratulations.
Our Clio Cup winner of the season, it's Hector Thompson. Congratulations, man. You really deserved it. So, yeah.
Let's let all the guys finish before we jump over. And we'll have a talk to them.
Lars, Clyde, and Andre Günther are the last guys who are racing.
Yeah, big gaps.
Yeah, really big gaps. Caused because of the carnage in the first few laps we had.
So here we are watching Lars, who's missed the chicane on the last lap. That'll be embarrassing to watch. Across the line. Decent ninth place. Let's jump to Clyde, who's got Paul coming up with him. Paul, unfortunately, four laps down, so something obviously happened there.
Yeah, he was involved, I think, at the lap 3 incident where two guys were took out.
Here
and
comes
he
Clyde.
Had to repair.
Well done, Clyde.
Andre is also now over the line.
And Paul is over the line. So right, let's go and jump over and go and speak to some people. Wow, guys, wow. That was an absolute... Well, I don't know what to say. That was a great race. Really, really was. Rich, I have to say, I thought from the moment you got up into 5th or 6th behind that big group, I said to Stefan, I thought that that was going to be your race, and it turned out to be. Just out of interest, what tyres were you on?
I was on the wets, mate.
You were on the wets? We were trying to figure out who was on what, but... Yeah, I think Carter, by the look of it, was on the wrong tyres. He was really struggling, backing you all up. But really, really, really was some great race with yourself, Pete, Hector, Lewis and David. Talk us through it, Rich, that kind of mid-phase of the race where you went up from 6th to 1st.
Well, there was like a massive sort of focus on tyre wear because the wets... were the tyre to be on, but the degradation was insane around there, like really, really bad. We find it in the BTCC car as well, like in on the dry tyres. But so the mid phase, I can't really remember who I was behind, but I sort of sat behind three of them and just thought, you know what, the lead pack are coming back to us. I'm just going to sit here for a few laps and try and conserve some tyre and see what happens, and luckily it seemed to pay off right at the end there. I had just left less than like one pip on my front left. It was absolutely knackered, so it seemed about right.
Yeah, it's brilliant. And we saw Hector manage to do this move around the outside of one of the corners. I think it was Church, the fast right-hander. He managed to get around the outside of Lewis to end up behind you. It was quite incredible, really, that he managed to hold it to stick. Pete, some great defensive driving we saw from you there. Did you have fun? It certainly looked like that you probably did.
I had a ball, actually. It's probably one of the first times that I've been out front in a race. I knew I didn't have the pace of Lewis or David. I never do. They're very good drivers. They did a very good job of blocking my advances, hence moving backwards towards Rich.
Yeah, we could see it, mate. We could see the gap. It was something like 12 seconds, and then it was just decreasing so rapidly, and then all of a sudden it was 5, and then it was 2, and then it was like there was the group of all 6 of you.
Yeah, I mean, I in hindsight, what do you do? You conserve tyres, and I didn't. I was absolutely bombing it the entire time. So I had nothing
but agree, and yeah, all of you. Yeah, it's really, really good to watch. Luke, anything happen with you? worth mentioning or standard?
I got hit, which is pretty normal by my standards. I went
he
wide
did roll.
To let, well, I went wide to let my teammate pass, and as I came back onto the race line to join for the next corner, someone, I can't remember who, decided to turn in on the apex same time as me and just hit me right in the front and damaged my car, so that set me back a bit and ruined my tyres, so yeah, not a very good race for me.
Unfortunate to hear that. You do seem to get some bad luck, Luke. Clyde, anything of note? Did you enjoy that one? The changeable condition is obviously quite difficult. So
I didn't hit you this time, Clyde.
No. Well done, everyone.
I think you hit somebody else who hit me.
Oh, here we go.
Right, anyway, guys, we'll let you guys keep talking. I'm going to stop the broadcast for now. Hopefully it was all right. We had, I think, a peak of 8 people watching, which I suppose isn't really a lot, but we had a comment from somebody called Mr. George 138. Well, yeah,
more
it will be.
Top gear, yeah.
But, no, cool, guys, and I'm going to stop the stream, and
cheers.
We'll see you later. Bye.